You're listening to the Rusted Robot Podcast, the number one rated robot-related podcast in northeastern Ontario.
Hello, and welcome to episode 176 of the Rusted Robot Podcast for Sunday, November the 26th, 2017. I'm your host, Sean, with Josh.
Hello!
And today we have his lovely wife, Kitty.
Woohoo!
And my lovely lady, Cheryl, who may or may not say words on the podcast.
My name is Optimus Prime.
Hello, I am C-3PO Human Cyborg Relations.
I am Locutus of Borg. Resistance is futile.
You're like a machine underneath, right? But sort of alive outside.
I'm a cybernetic organism, living tissue over a metal endoskeleton.
You're not quite human, are you?
No, sir. I'm an android.
These aren't the droids we're looking for.
Counterfeit facsimile replica!
We need some sort of robot! Ah, crap! I'm some sort of robot!
What are your prime directives?
Serve the public trust, protect the innocent, uphold the law.
By your command.
So, here we are, episode 176, and guess what? Something exciting happened this past week.
Do tell!
Well, on episode 47...
47.
...of the You, Me, and Duffy podcast, they played a promo for the Rusted Robot.
How exciting.
It is very exciting. And I was talking to the guys, and they sent us a promo, and we're going to play it right here.
Hey everyone, I'm Jason.
I'm Scott.
And I'm Duffy.
Together, we are You, Me, and Duffy.
We're three friends that know a little about a lot and everything about nothing.
Come join our kooky conversations.
We talk nerd and geek and pop culture across all mediums,
all while sharing a drink.
Search for us on social media. You know, that thing that the kids are doing.
We want to hear from all of you.
So if you want to know which one of us can only poop at Space Mountain,
which one of us is a never nude,
or which one of us wants to be a supervillain,
then catch us every Sunday on Apple Podcasts or your podcatcher of choice.
Don't forget to subscribe, rate, and review.
And as always,
you know what they say.
And that is the promo for You, Me, and Duffy, which is an American version, kind of in the same vein as us.
Okay.
A little bit harsher language than what we do on our show.
So they cuss.
They do cuss. They say
words like... And... And...
Right, just like that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I see.
Yeah, so I've listened to a few of their shows, and I like it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'll check them out.
Very good.
Me and Duffy.
You, Me, and Duffy.
You can find those on any of the podcasting catchers, right?
That's what they said.
All right, we'll look them up.
All right. Hey, you know what's happening at the end of the year?
The end of the world?
It just might.
Okay.
That never happens. And I always pass up getting a t-shirt.
Yeah, well, you should have got a t-shirt the last end of the world.
I really should have. The next time there's an end of the world, I will get an end of the world t-shirt.
But also happening at the end of the year, December 31st, 2017.
Northern Ontario Expo.
New Year's Gala.
New Year's Gala dance.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's happening at the Senator Hotel where we had the Halloween dance.
Yeah. Except this one's going to be, like, formal.
This is a formal dance.
Yep.
Gala.
It's going to be super nice.
It is. Where can we get tickets, Josh?
You can get them from Alfie Cigar Store.
That's on 3rd Avenue, right?
Yeah. Or Wicked Stuff in the Timmins Square.
Yeah.
Or you can get them from this place called Jump City Comics. I've never been there, but I hear it's kind of interesting.
It's super hella cool, guys.
Is it? How do you know about it?
I am one of the two owners.
Oh, yeah. That's where
we've heard it from. All right.
Where can we find this shop?
In Timmins.
Where?
At 229 Pine Street South, Timmins, Ontario, in Canada.
Oh, that's not too far from here.
No.
All right, so we can get tickets for the New Year's Eve Formal Gala at Wicked Stuff, Jump City, and Alfie's Cigar Store.
Yes.
Tickets are $60 each, I hear.
Yes.
Yeah, it's because it's got a super nice catered meal.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And the hours are from 8 till 2.
Yeah.
So looking forward to that.
Yeah, it's going to be really nice. I never have a place to wear a really, really nice dress to.
You don't?
And Josh is getting a suit this year,
getting a suit?
He needs a tie.
Oh, I've heard of a place called WeAreDapperTies.com. Did you know about it?
I have heard of it, I think, before.
Probably on past episodes of the Rusted Robot Podcast,
yeah.
Which is what we're doing right now. We're actually recording episode 176.
You don't say.
I do. I just said it several times, in fact, on this recording. So, we are dappertize.com. Put in promo code RUSTED, and you can get free shipping on your ties, Josh.
I can?
Yeah.
Well, what kind of ties do they have?
I don't know. You should go to the website right now on your phone and check it out.
Huh. Let's see. We are dappertize.com. Right. Ooh, they got a nice purple stripe tag going on.
Ooh, purple's my favorite color.
Ooh, I like the burgundy one.
Yeah, these are some nice ties. I think I might get one of these for my new suit.
You should. Is it going to be a zoot suit?
I asked him the same question.
Prices are reasonable, too. Only $15 for some of those ties.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Right? And fill up your cart. Buy multiple ties for Christmas for people and get free shipping when you put in promo code.
Yeah, free shipping. Can't go wrong there.
Rusted. Promo code Rusted. That's very exciting. And now that all that business is out of the way, what are we going to talk about first?
Well, I heard you and your lady checked out Justice League.
In fact, Cheryl and I went to see Justice League last night.
Yeah, and what do you think?
What did you think, Cheryl?
I didn't care for it.
She didn't care for it.
Really?
She's sitting far away from the microphone, so I don't know if it's going to pick her up or not. But
Thor was 1,000 times better.
I really enjoyed Thor a lot, but my sister went and saw Justice League, and she said she loved it.
And Robin, who was on the podcast last week, he gave it an 8 out of 10.
Yeah, she said that there was some music in there that was reminiscent of the Justice League animated series.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and she said that they felt a lot like that, so she really enjoyed it.
So, what would you give it on a scale of 10?
Okay, on a scale of 10, I was trying to think about this, and we went to the show, so that gives it a bump. And I give everything too high of a rating anyway, so I'm thinking it was better than Alien Covenant, which I gave a 6.5. So I'd give this about a 7.
Okay, a 7. And yours, what would you give it?
6.
A 6. All right. So 6.5 average. No.
Yeah, 6 no. And 7. 6.5.
7 is the average.
Because of Robin?
Because of Robin. Dragging it up.
Of course.
Should we go and see it, Josh, or have you seen it?
I have not yet seen the movie.
Should we go and see it?
I've been hearing, like, either I love it or I hate it.
Well, Julie said she really liked it, and she loves, like, Batman the Animated Series, Green Lantern Animated Series, Justice League Animated Series, Superman Animated Series, and that's what I'm hella into. And my friend Jeff, who follows the comics, he really enjoyed it and said it was good. So, I trust both of their opinions.
Well, I neither loved it nor hated it, but I enjoyed it well enough. It was okay.
Shane, who is absent again, said that he enjoyed it, but then he did spend most of the rest of the time talking about how things they got wrong. So I'm not sure what that means.
Well, I did make sure to pay attention to the CGI of Cyborg to talk to you about that, because I know you were concerned.
Yeah.
And it didn't bother me at all. It was fine.
Okay.
That didn't take me out, nothing like that. And Robin was talking about Superman's CGI'd off mustache. And you could kind of tell it looked like he had a weird lip, but it was not too bad.
Actually, yeah, that's the one and only complaint that I heard from everybody who saw it, that he had a weird lip.
Yeah, it was a little bit weird, but it wasn't too bad.
Yeah.
It just looked like he was kind of grimacing.
Plus, it was like so near like the beginning of the movie.
That's right.
They said it didn't really matter.
It didn't. And it was fine. You said it dragged in the middle, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't find it too bad. It was just okay. It was all right. I'm glad I saw it in the theater. Would I buy it? If it was on sale.
If it was on sale.
I'd watch it again if you wanted to go with me, and I'd go see it again. But I wouldn't go out of my way to go see it again.
Yeah, okay.
So it was all right.
All right. All right. Moving on. So I checked out, and I think you did as well, and you, the Runaways. Marvel's Runaways.
We did.
So what'd you think?
It was all right. I will watch another episode to see how it goes. I didn't really care that much, but it was enough to keep me intrigued.
Okay. I didn't like it that much.
Yeah?
The everybody falls in their little box trope kind of hurt. Like, to the point of, like, I was getting annoyed by it.
Okay.
Particularly the jock feminist trope thing that they got going on there. That angered me. Like, come on.
Like, they didn't have diverse enough characters.
Not that they didn't...
They fit into the boxes.
Yeah, they each character fit into their nice little box perfectly each and every time.
Yes.
And it was boring in that respect.
Yeah.
You didn't get to anything interesting. Like, you got the murder in the first episode, and you had the rewind episode. A total waste of an episode.
Yeah, the second episode really wasn't necessary, was it?
No, because the story's going to be about the kids.
Yeah.
We don't need a recap of what happened from the parents' point of view.
No, not really. I don't know who the guy in the mask in the secret bedroom is.
That's her father.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay. Did we know that already?
We were able to deduce it.
Okay. I don't know if I was paying that much attention because it was kind of meh.
So that's what I said.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
So, yeah. It's the father. I don't... I'll give it one or two more episodes.
That's what I'm thinking.
But that's it. That's all I want to do.
Right. Yeah, it was fine. It's
if it doesn't pick up in the next two episodes,
you're gonna drop it.
I'm gonna drop it.
Drop it like it's hot, Josh.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of things on TV, and when I was watching Runaways, it said presented by Hulu.
Yes.
Okay. But I saw it on Showcase, so I don't know what the deal is. Maybe Showcase is a division of Hulu or something. But I saw a commercial during Runaways for Happy. Do you remember Happy? We talked about it on a previous episode. It's the one with Christopher Maloney as the hitman.
Yes, guy. And he's got the imaginary friend thing going on.
Oh, yeah. Yes. And it's like a weird unicorn. A
weird, magical, pooping unicorn.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, during the Showcase presentation of Runaways, there was a commercial for Happy, and it's going to be on Showcase December 7th. So it's not going to be on Hulu only. We're going to be able to watch it here in Canada.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. So next week sometime, or the week after, whatever it is.
All right.
So that's cool.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
That looked like a weird and interesting show, so I was kind of hoping to check it out.
Give it a few episodes to go.
Yeah. I want to watch it.
Do you?
It looks funny.
It looks like it's something right up your alley.
Yeah. So. Plus, I really like the guy, the main character.
Right, Chris Maloney.
Yeah.
Stabler from SVU.
Yeah.
Law and Order.
I liked him a lot.
Right.
The unstable Stabler?
Yes. Yeah. That's the one.
Every time I said for him to pistol whip somebody, he did. And it made me happy.
You've got some deep-seated issues, don't you?
Everybody in Law and Order deserved it.
Well. Moving along.
If you're loving this podcast, you should tell a friend about it.
Spread the word about podcasts you think they would enjoy.
There's something for everyone, from entertainment and lifestyle
to news and politics
and more. Share it on social media.
Believe it or not, some people don't know how great podcasts are
or even how to find and listen to them.
You can help change that with a click.
Tell your friends about your favorite podcast.
Thanks for spreading the word.
Before we get into something really cool, we have something really disturbing that Cheryl and I came across today. Why don't you tell them what we came across today on the commercials?
Trumpy Bear.
Okay.
So, for two easy payments of $19.99, you can get your very own patriotic Trumpy Bear.
It's a teddy bear with Donald Trump hair, the toupee, and you can brush it. And stuffed inside the teddy bear is a U.S. flag blanket.
Oh.
And you can snuggle up to it while you're snuggling up to your Trumpy Bear.
I thought you were going to say it was stuffed with hate.
And that's not all. It also comes with a certificate of authenticity for two easy payments of $20.
Mm-hmm. Who makes this thing?
I thought it was a fake commercial because it was so ridiculous when it came on. I'm like, this can't be real. Because they had some guy on a marine on a motorcycle saying, I love driving around with my Trumpy Bear on the front of my bike.
Curious.
It was ridiculous.
And they have a website. What was it, trumpybear.com?
Probably. And if I can find this commercial on YouTube, I'm going to insert it right here. And if not, then you'll just have to find it because it's ridiculous.
I'm a little bit surprised that they called it a Trumpy Bear because it's like, it's a creature, right?
Trumpy Bear. Oh, hang on. I can play the trailer right here, right now.
The wind whispered through the forest. A storm is coming. You cannot defeat the storm. From the trees rose a resounding voice. I fear nothing. I come when the trumpet sounds. I am the storm, the great American grizzly. Introducing the original Trumpy Bear, the fearless, super plush American grizzly. Trumpy Bear was born June 14th, Flag Day. Just find the secret zipper and pull out the American flag themed blanket. Then wrap yourself in the red, white, and blue for comfort and warmth. Show your patriotism and proudly display Trumpy on Flag Day and on any American holiday.
God bless America and God bless Trumpy Bear.
Trumpy Bear sits proudly at the front of the motorcycle for all the world to see and loves to cruise with his brother.
I'm a former Marine and I'm proud to have Trumpy Bear ride by my side. Once a Marine, always a Marine.
Everyone knows Trumpy Bear loves to go to the golf course.
When I ride with Trumpy Bear, he makes my golf game great again. Thank you, Trumpy Bear.
Trumpy Bear can pop up anywhere. Simply style his trademark hair and place him in his favorite chair. Even the toughest guys will love Trumpy Bear.
When America's great, business is great. When business is great, I am great. I love you, Trumpy Bear.
I am an Army veteran. I am proud to own the Trumpy Bear, and I will always be proud to be an American.
Order the Super Plus Trumpy Bear for only two payments of $19.95 and receive a special certificate of authenticity. Don't miss out on owning a piece of American history. Order now for only two payments of $19.95. Trumpy, the most fearless bear anywhere. Order now.
Okay, so.
That's very confusing.
Doesn't that seem like a fake commercial?
Yes.
It's ridiculous, right?
Yes.
What do you think, Josh?
Okay, while the thing was playing, I was looking up, is Trumpy Bear a joke? And according to the first news site that I grabbed, maybe.
Oh, really?
They're not sure.
Okay. Because it just seems so ridiculous that it has to be fake.
No, I think it is a real product.
All right.
Okay. I kind of assumed it would have, like, removable hair and be stuffed with hate.
But is it a real product? Or is it a gag product?
Like, making fun of Trump?
Yeah.
Because I don't know.
It's so weird.
The commercial makes it seem like it's a gag product.
Right, because it's too earnest and too sweet. And what does it say? I can't read that. Read it to me. Non-U.S. orders... Oh, Make America Great Again is a trademark of Donald J. Trump for President, Inc. No endorsement is implied or granted. Hat is not included and not offered for sale. Quantities will be limited, so order today to ensure you will receive a Trump Bear before they sell out or hit retirement. Wow.
I think it's something that he's doing as a promotional thing.
Wow.
Because he needs more money.
Wow. I don't think so, because that's saying, oh, we don't own the MAGA hat. We don't. We don't. So don't sue us. So I think...
There is a copyright on it.
I think it's a gag product. I think it's a product that hipsters will buy, like millennials will buy. It's like, oh, look at the Trumpy Bear, right?
Irony.
Yeah.
I'm kind of surprised they didn't call it the Trumpet.
Why?
Because it's a pet.
Oh.
It's like a stuffed animal creature.
Well, it's more of a play Trump. On the teddy bear. Because the teddy bear was named after Teddy Roosevelt.
Yeah.
And he was a president.
Yeah.
So now it's Trumpy.
But, like, Theodore Roosevelt saved a bear from being shot. Well, actually, he just saved it from being tortured longer than it had to be.
Is that true?
Yeah. Yeah. People used to, call it bear baiting. You would bait the bear to the tree, and then you would catch it and chain it to the tree, and then continue to torture it until it died.
That's not very nice.
Yeah, well, Theodore Roosevelt agreed and said that nobody should be doing that anymore, and he made it illegal, and so... In commemoration of him being, like, a humane-to-animals person, they called it the teddy bear.
Ah, very cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why do I know that?
I have no idea. I've never heard that story.
Oh.
But now I have.
Surprise! You learn something every day when you hang out with me.
Yes, yes, you do. Hey, so I would just like to take this time, speaking of Trumpy Bear and stuff, to wish our American listeners a belated Happy Thanksgiving. Because they just had that on Thursday.
Oh yeah, happy Thanksgiving!
And on Friday, we all had the Black Friday deals.
Ugh.
Did you take advantage of Black Friday?
You know what? For Black Friday, Jump City had a special magic promotion.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, we had a special deal going on for promotional packs for everybody who bought a full box, a booster box of magic.
Mm-hmm.
But that is all.
Ah.
Because we aren't an American company.
Right.
We're just a family-run store, so we don't do the Black Friday sales.
Okay. Well, I needed a new phone for a long time. For the last 3 months, I've been carrying around a charger with me because my phone would die after 5 minutes of constant use. Like, if I'm texting somebody for more than 5 minutes, the phone would just die, so I had to carry a charger around. But I took advantage of the Black Friday deals on this Thursday. I got a new iPhone, an iPhone 7.
Is it the rose gold one?
They asked if I wanted that, and I said, no, I don't.
You didn't want rose gold?
Well, first, he didn't know what rose gold was.
I said, yeah, what is rose gold? Pink. Oh, it's pink. It's pink. I don't want a pink phone.
It's not pink. It's rose gold.
Okay, but
the story... Julie knows all about it.
The story is, I went to TELUS, because that's my provider.
Yes.
And so I go to TELUS, and I said, I need a new phone. This one's a piece of crap. What do you got for deals? Well, what was it, $50 for the iPhone 7 there? Or was it $0?
No, it was more than that. Well, it was 100 and something, and they said to go to Best Buy.
Yeah, the lady at TELUS told me to go over to Best Buy. So she turned the business away so I could get a better deal. So I went to Best Buy, and I could get the iPhone 7 for $0, keep my same plan, and get a free pair of earpods. But their systems were down, and they were out of earpods. So
you didn't get the deal.
I didn't get that deal, but I went. Then we went to Walmart.
Okay.
And I got the iPhone 7 for $0. I got to keep my same plan, and they gave me a $200 Walmart gift card. So here's a free phone and some money.
That's weird.
Okay, thanks. I had to sign the new 2-year contract, but whatever.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Who cares? And then they were having deals on movies, so it was Monkey Thursday. I picked up Kong Skull Island and War for the Planet of the Apes, because they were on sale.
What is Monkey Thursday?
Just two movies that I picked up were monkey related.
Ah,
so it became Monkey Thursday.
I thought it was just becoming a thing now that the Rusted Robot would do.
Ooh, Monkey Thursday. I like it.
Josh, you do not seem pleased by this.
You don't want to do Monkey Thursdays? We can have a supplemental episode. Just like a 20-minute Monkey Thursday.
And what would this entail? This is production meeting stuff that we shouldn't really be recording.
Oh, it's just funny. It's amusing because Katie brought it up.
Okay.
I brought it up.
You brought it up.
Yes.
I just said I bought some monkey-related movies on Thursday.
Oh.
You made it a thing.
You made it a thing.
It's always a thing.
Oh, okay.
And I make it.
Well, you are the editor.
I am the editor.
And the producer.
And the producer.
Yeah. You make all the things that have
the director and the writer.
Yeah.
There's a writing staff?
You didn't know?
Sometimes I write things down. We get scripts? I don't know if that counts.
Yes.
Oh.
They're terrible.
They are terrible. So that's why we throw them out. So.
Oh, that's what I've been throwing out.
Yes. Okay. Yes, there you go. What else have we watched? Anything else exciting and new? Oh, I've been watching Stranger Things. I finally got into it. I'm at episode 6 and a bit.
6 and a bit season 1, 6 and a bit season 2.
Season 2. I watched season 1 last year, twice.
Isn't it great? Don't you love it?
I do. I finally had a chance to relax today and not shovel snow, so I got to watch some Stranger Things. And you got to watch some Stranger Things with me. What did you think?
Strange.
Strange?
It's implied in the name.
Yeah, I found it a little strange. I think I have to watch a few more episodes before I can form an opinion.
Did you get to watch season 1?
She hasn't watched season
1. Oh, okay.
Then you can't watch season 2. You're doing it wrong, Sean. Yeah,
you're out of the loop, that's why.
I was just catching one that he was watching.
Yeah, oh, okay.
You gotta go back and watch season 1. It's really good.
It makes a lot more sense. Like, if you just jumped in, you'd be so lost and not invested in any of the characters.
Yeah, I think she started on season 2, episode 4, so yeah.
It is really, really good, but you have to start, like, right from the beginning. It's not one of those shows where you can just watch. It's not like The Simpsons. But, we finally watched the end of Stranger Things.
And don't give me any spoilers.
But it's good.
It was good?
Yeah.
And I haven't got to Punisher yet. That's after Stranger Things.
It ends the same way as Rogue One. Everybody dies.
Nice. How'd you find Punisher?
We really enjoyed it.
Yeah?
Did
you watch? I was listening to a previous episode. You were going to watch all 13 in one day. Did you do it?
We could not.
What? I'm disappointed.
No, I can't. I can't just watch all of Punisher in one day. All
right. How many days did it take you?
It
took us 3 sittings.
Yeah.
Okay, not bad. And 13 episodes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's okay. Like, I liked it, but...
Was it super violent?
Yeah, but like, you know, it's Punisher, so...
Well, yeah.
The only thing that I didn't like is that... Because, like, you know how he is in Daredevil?
Yeah.
Well, it's okay for Frank Castle to be such a shallow character. Like, he's got very little...
Backstory?
To him?
Yeah.
Well, like, he has a backstory, but, like, you know, he's like, I'm sad, and I like to kill people. And that's all. So
this gives him more depth.
No, he's just kind of the same depth all the way through.
He's still sad and just likes to kill people.
Yeah, he's just sad. And he's like, oh, I'm sad. So but, like, he's not a whiner either. So he's like, I'm sad, and I like to kill people. And in the show, he establishes that he's always liked killing people.
So it's 13 episodes of sadness and death?
No, because the other characters are what makes it worth watching.
Okay.
Josh and I are actually really big fans of Agent Madani.
Okay, I don't know who
that is. She's hella cool. I think she was the main reason why I wound up watching it. Because, like, you have to have Punisher in there, obviously, because, like, he's the driving force of the show. And without him, it would just be corrupt people being corrupt and not getting their comeuppance. So Frank Castle's really important. Oh, also, other guy, who I'm not going to say anything about, but there's another guy with curly hair, and he also makes the show worth watching. He likes chamomile tea. Oh. I can't say other things, though, because it will spoil it.
Okay.
Actually, I really enjoyed Madani's partner.
Yeah! I really liked him, too, but I can't say anything about him without spoilers. So I really liked him also.
All right.
And it was all the side characters that made it worth watching to me, because other than that, there's just Frank Castle, who would be whiny, but is so stoic and also alone that he never says anything about himself being sad, and he just runs around killing people.
All right.
Frank Castle is an event rather than a character.
Yeah, because there's very little to him by himself. Like, we don't even know if he likes music, really. We know that he can play guitar.
Oh.
But we don't really know how well, because he only plays, like, the same riff over and over again. Like, a kid playing, like, dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun, but it's something else. So that's, like,
That was pretty good. Do that again.
Oh, it's smoke on the water.
Let's not incur, you know, monies.
Yeah, well, no, I wasn't going to do the whole thing.
I know, but you were getting close to the time limit.
No, it doesn't count. It doesn't count.
It's how long you play it for. It doesn't matter how much of it you play.
That's fine.
If the Rusted Robot podcast has enough listeners to have to pay royalties, and we get a court case out of it, and we get that much more promotion, I think you should go ahead and do the whole thing.
Smoke on the water.
Because any publicity is good publicity.
No, that's not true.
You don't think so?
No. I can think of lots of cases where it was just bad publicity.
Don't you want to be famous?
No.
Not as much as I want to be rich.
Internet famous.
No. I just want to give my opinions and people recognize that I'm right and then leave me alone.
Oh, I see. I see how this works.
Yep.
All right.
And you know what's wrong with that opinion? Nothing, because I'm right.
Of course you are. Course.
But yeah, I think as far as characters go, I enjoyed watching Punisher, but I think I prefer the character of Danny Rand more, because he's not so dark. I know he likes hip-hop, he believes in things, but he's got weird family drama past, and I don't know. You know the character more, and there's more to him than just, like, the two things, because he's also sad.
Danny Rand is sad?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he also deals with it through violence. But he's not a violent guy, and he doesn't promote violence. And he does other things.
He has an iron fist.
He does! He loves telling people that he's the iron fist! I love him! He's a child!
Living weapon. Sworn enemy of the hand. The iron fist is... it's me. Are you Danny Rand, or are you the iron fist? I'm both. I am the iron fist.
I'm the Iron Fist. People find out I'm the Iron Fist.
I am the Iron Fist. I am the Iron Fist. Protector of Kanlan. I'm the Iron Fist. But I'm Danny Rand. And I'm the Iron Fist. I'm the Immortal Iron Fist.
You what?
He's a big child that just runs around telling people, I'm the Immortal Iron Fist, guys.
Hey, look at me.
Does anybody want to hear about my secret city of Kung Lung? And they're like, secret city? And he's like, oh, no.
Never mind.
But do you want to hear about it? So, I don't mind him as much, because at least he's humorous. He's bad, but yes. He's humorous. You'll probably like Punisher.
I can't wait. But yeah. At first I had to finish off Stranger Things.
Stranger Things is the best one, though.
I like season one more than I like season two.
Yeah, eh?
You want to know something exciting?
I always want to know something exciting.
So, you know how Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition... has miniatures and grid boards to make it easier to have reference as to where your characters are in the game?
Let's say yes, I did know that.
Okay, so that is a thing, And now because Stranger Things is so popular, they are making a special set of miniatures that includes the Demogorgon as one of the monsters.
Oh.
And the Demogorgon is the exact same Demogorgon figure as used from the Stranger Things episode 1.
Nice.
Yeah.
So it is the Demogorgon in the game, in the show, not the Demogorgon in the show.
Yeah, that they actually fight, yeah.
Because the Demogorgon in the show is a creature that they name the Demogorgon after the Demogorgon in the game in the show that they're playing.
Yeah, just because it's the big monster?
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're not actually that much alike.
No.
I might add the Demogorgon in D&D is not a creature I've come across and I have been playing for 20 years.
Uh-huh.
So it's a creature they made up for the show.
Okay.
For the game in the show.
Right.
Yeah, I've also never encountered...
So that they can call the thing in the show after the thing in the game in the show.
Yeah, I've also never encountered a Demogorgon, because it would be a half-Gorgon, which is a half of a creature that can turn something to stone, like a Medusa.
Yeah.
Yeah. We've never encountered a Demogorgon, which is a half-Gorgon.
So where can we get this figure?
You can get it at Jump City and probably many other game stores.
Really?
Not right now. Oh. It won't be available until sometime during December.
Oh, we're just in time for Christmas.
Yeah, but it will only be a special promotional monster if you purchase the whole $94 kit.
Oh, well.
Hella worth it, though. You get totally worth it. There's like a whole bunch of other monsters, and they come pre-painted.
So you don't even have to do the work.
Yeah.
Well,
there you go. I like not doing the work.
Yeah. I also like not doing the work.
I concur.
And it's a special collector set.
Well, if there's one thing I'm all about, it's all about the special collector sets.
Yeah.
How are those totes going?
Are they totes cool?
Totally.
Oh, they're being kept cool, all right, in the cooling room downstairs in the basement.
That's good. Good to hear.
We're making room. We're making progress. Slowly reducing the piles of things that I have.
That's good.
Very slowly, glacially, but it's coming along.
I told you to set up your old house as a museum.
It's not a bad idea.
That way you can get more stuff instead of less.
Josh and I really like stuff.
I've got lots of stuff.
Yeah.
Is it the same type of stuff that we would like, though?
Probably. Let's just say that it is.
Yeah?
Okay. Yeah. I think you'd like all my stuff.
I like getting stuff and having stuff.
But you said you wouldn't sell it to me.
Not for a dollar.
You agreed to the price.
Yeah, I know. We're not going through that again, are we?
You're going to sell it to me for a dollar?
No?
All right. Boss said no, so it's no.
No. It's 25 years worth of collecting. I just can't get rid of it for a dollar.
$2.
Well,
that might be tempting.
Woohoo!
That's pretty tempting, I'll tell you. Yeah.
I actually have some comic news, too.
You do? Tell me.
Yeah, okay. So I have read through one entire... Actually, it's a graphic novel. It's not available as singles.
Oh.
Yeah, sorry. It's called Witch Boy.
Witch Boy?
Yeah. It came out on October 31st, 2017.
Oh, it was just recently.
Yeah, it's a Scholastic book. It is about a boy named Aster whose family is born with magic. The boys grow up to be shapeshifters and the girls turn into witches. Apparently there's no exceptions. But Aster can't seem to get the hang of shapeshifting. Instead, he spends all of his time spying on witchery lessons the girls are getting. And he seems to have a knack for casting spells and he wants to know more. But the only person he can share his growing gift with is Charlie, a girl from a non-magical side of town. Then one night of shapeshifting practice, one of the boys goes missing. Aster knows he can search for the boy with witchcraft that he's been secretly learning. It's a story by Molly Ostertag. I believe she does both the art and the actual story.
Oh, multitasker.
Very yeah, because nice. It's only got the one name, and it's the only one that I've been able to find. And she worked on another book previously, but I believe only as the illustrator.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I've read all the way through this thing, so I can't give any spoilers.
It doesn't sound very interesting, is it?
It is really good.
Yeah, you like it?
Yeah, it's like a mystery, and it has to do with magic.
Mm-hmm.
It also has to do with, like, finding your place in the world as a young person.
Oh.
Yeah, so like...
So, life lessons.
Well, like, it's almost like finding your literal place in the world.
Oh, okay.
Because, like, he's a boy who prefers magic that he's not supposed to have.
Right.
So, like, everybody's like, no, you have to be a shapeshifter because you're a boy.
Right.
And okay. He's like, well, I'm good at this magic. And they're like, too bad.
Oh.
But he winds up, like, being really good at that and helping to actually solve a mystery and also fight forces of evil with his witch powers, which is pretty sweet.
That sounds pretty sweet to me.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it, like, a lot. I think it's buy-worthy. It's not just read-worthy.
So it's better than it sounds.
Yeah.
Okay. All about life lessons.
Yeah, well, because I can't, like, I can't say too much else without giving away all of the
story. Out of 10, how many rivets?
I'd say probably an 8, because it's buy-worthy. I kind of wish that there was more to it. That's why it won't get a higher score from me, because, like, that's it. There's only the one book, and then it wraps up all nice and together, which some people really like, but I kind of wish that there was more, because I really like this character.
Well, if you like more, did you know there's a new podcast called The Soul Forge Podcast, all about more stuff and life lessons and being a better person?
Yes!
Welcome to The Soul Forge, a place of silent mystery, quiet contemplation, and outright mayhem. Join your host, Sean Vanderloo, as he guides you through the adventures of living. Together, we'll talk about life and love, sex and dating, joy and heartache, memories and loss, and so much more. Don't worry, it's not nearly as pretentious as it sounds. Get ready for life, the universe, and everything on The Soul Forge.
You did know about this.
Yeah, I listened to some of it today.
Oh, the latest episode?
I listened to the one where you were packing up your totes and threw out 2 garbage bags worth of stuff.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because I've been doing that.
Yep. I heard as such.
What else you got for us?
Well, there's another comic. This one is only available as single issues. Yeah. It's called Fence. Novelist C.S. Paquette, author of Captive Prince, and fan favorite artist Joanna the Mad, team up for a new series perfect for fans of Check Please and Yuri on Ice. 16-year-old Nicholas Cox is an outsider to the competitive fencing world. Filled with raw talent but lacking proper training, he signs up for a competition that puts him head-to-head with fencing prodigy Sanji Katayama and on the road to an elite all-boys school Kings Row. A chance at a real team and a place to belong awaits him if he can make the cut. It's like a sports...
I hate sports.
Yeah, I know, but it's like fencing, so it's not like the same thing.
Captain Picard was good at fencing.
Captain Picard was good at fencing. Like, not all sports are really the same. Like, it's not the same thing as, like, say, basketball or hockey. Fencing's sword fighting, and it's hella-ass cool.
Isn't the only time we see Picard fencing isn't that...
the episode where he gets stabbed by Guinan?
Yeah.
So he's not that good at fencing?
Well, we've only seen it once. I think there's that weird time loop thing.
I think we saw it twice. I can't remember what other episode it is, but I do recall twice.
Wasn't he also fencing on the holodeck once?
That's where he always fences.
Yeah.
Because there's once against Guinan.
Yeah, and I think there was some dude that he was fighting once.
Was it a hologram?
I don't remember that. I only remember Guinan, yeah. And it's because that had that weird time thing in it.
Right, yes.
Anyways.
This one's mostly about, like, the characters.
So it's not about fancy swords play?
A lot of it is about fancy swordplay.
But it's all about the characters, so it's going to be hyper...
It's just like the characters, their solid main interest is fencing. It's just then you wind up caring about their personalities and about how they're all very different. And then relationships blossom.
All right, moving on.
Yeah, that's great. So this can all be found at your comic book store, Jump City, located at 229 Pine Street South in Timmins, Ontario.
Canada, Earth, Sol System, Milky Way, Local Galactic Cluster, the Universe, the Megaverse.
It's good to have more options, though, right? Because, like, everybody already knows about Spider-Man, Superman, Batman.
Who are these people that you're talking
Wonder
about?
Wonder Woman.
Let me tell you. Gal Gadot as Wonder Woman?
I thought it was Gadot.
I don't know how you say her name. I don't even care.
Oh.
It doesn't matter.
Oh. I'm pretty sure she cares.
She's a pretty model.
She is a very pretty model.
She's not the best she could be as
did
a Wonder
Did you know
Wonder
she
Woman.
Did all of her own stunts in the movie?
That's very good for her.
Yeah. She took up a self-defense and fighting course with a...
Dude, she's from Israel. Yeah. And all the Israeli people have to be in the army when they turn 18, so she's a badass warrior anyway. She knows her stuff.
I don't think they're taught with swords and shields.
No, but they have guns. And combat training.
I don't know. I don't know about that.
She's pretty, okay? That's all I was trying to say.
Okay, she is very pretty, but she...
How
I think
dare
she's
you
cool.
objectify her?
Too late. The movie did it for me. In fact, there's a scene...
The whole point of the movie is not to objectify her, that she's a powerful, independent creature, independent of her looks.
Yes, I agree with that. But Arthur Curry, who is the alternate name for Aquaman, played by Jason Momoa, actually says in the movie how hot she is.
Yes.
So I am just repeating information that I've already heard.
Oh. Well, you'd probably like it. Josh didn't get to see Wonder Woman yet.
What?
No, I've seen it.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you like it? It's really good, eh?
I liked it.
I thought you would like it.
Yeah.
And she did all her own stunts.
Yeah.
That makes it extra cool.
Because she's a badass.
She's a great actress playing the Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
She's not a good Wonder Woman.
Well, you know, she's not worse than the new Man of Steel Superman.
At no point did I
stop
going Gal Gadot as Wonder Woman in my head.
Because she doesn't inhabit the character.
She really doesn't.
None of these people did. Maybe
she
Aquaman.
She did a pretty good job.
But we didn't like the Flash, did we? We didn't care for a Flash.
No.
No, and the suit was horrible too.
So he's no TV Flash?
He's no TV Flash. You can't beat Grant Gustin. But the guy who played Henry Allen did a very good impression of John Wesley Shipp as Henry Allen from the show.
So, like, if you're doing impressions of the TV show, just get the guys from the TV show.
Yeah. Agreed.
Anyways.
Oh, well. I thought she did a good job of being Wonder Woman. Maybe it's also because I've only seen, like, the one from the 70s.
Linda Carter?
Yeah. So, like, and she was a good Wonder Woman. Like, you know, a good 70s Wonder Woman.
I don't know. I never watched that show.
No? It's pretty fun.
I'm sure it is.
It's ridiculous.
I'm sure it's...
Did you like Adam West Batman?
Yeah, it was alright. It was fun.
Okay, they're in a similar boat.
I figured.
Yeah.
Yes.
But yeah.
Guess what time it is?
What time is it?
Time for an email.
Yeah. Get what we got, Mr. Roboto. It's another email.
Ooh! Is it from the Sparky and Guns?
As a matter of fact, it is.
Huzzah, huzzah! Kalu kale, what a joyous day.
Alright. The title of this email is, Whoever made the Wendy's Bacon Mushroom Melt needs to be given all the Nobel Peace Prizes.
I agree.
Do you?
Yes.
Good morrow, unoiled unicrons. Hope you all had a fantastic week of ingesting geek culture into your brain through electrical impulses sent from the optic nerve. Probably our favorite nerve of all time. This week, Guns went to Wendy's and ordered all the bacon mushroom melts. All of them. Each one went down better than the rest, and just as he was about to eat the last deliciously cheesy bite and do irreparable harm to his body, Sparky burst in, dove across the room, and ate the greasy bullet, saving a life and this week's email. This week's email is brought to you by Wendy's Bacon Mushroom Melt. Thanks, Wendy's. Guns would like to know, when it comes to fast food, sit-down restaurants, and a nice date night, what is your go-to pick for each?
Okay, so...
For Josh and I, for fast food, it's Wendy's, too.
I was also going to say Wendy's.
Yeah.
And Cheryl, what's your favorite fast food place?
McDonald's.
Really? Why? You don't fit in the play place anymore.
I like the Big Macs.
Ah.
All right, what about a fancy sit-down restaurant date type place?
Well, I believe those should be separated. A fancy restaurant and then...
Sit-down restaurants and a nice date night.
Yeah, so those are separate... things. Fancy rests, like a sit-down restaurant, our favorite's Golden Dragon.
Golden Dragon?
Yeah, we love the Golden Dragon.
A local restaurant, Chinese place. They have a decent buffet, and I like the atmosphere there. The staff is very friendly.
The staff knows who we are.
Oh, yeah?
We sit down, and they just bring us our coffee and our tea.
Hmm. They watched our children grow up.
Nice.
They know who they are when they go in with other people, and they know what they want.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
You're such a consumer.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, that'd be our go-to sit-down restaurant. Sean?
I don't really have a go-to sit-down restaurant. Maybe Eastside Mario's or Casey's.
Yeah, those are okay.
What would your sit-down restaurant of choice be?
We do Eastside's. We go with Julie and Paul and Mia.
Yeah.
And the girls have their little sit-down date.
Yeah, so Eastside's.
Always Eastside's.
Okay.
And then for a date night restaurant, I would like it to be Osaka because I love Osaka.
Sushi?
But Josh can't go there because it gives him migraines because of the lighting.
Oh.
They have this weird lighting thing, and it 40 minutes in, and I can't see because my migraines started.
Yeah.
oh, that's not good.
Yeah, and then he has to go and lie down somewhere and sleep for a long time. But we usually wind up going to Mike's restaurant because we can walk there and their food is good.
Oh, good choice. Mm-hmm. We don't really have a date restaurant place because we don't eat out that much, do we? No, I would pick a candlelit dinner on a beach with a nice soft breeze and a hurricane lamp to keep the candle lit, yeah.
It would fall over in the sand, the candle.
There's a table with a white tablecloth, and there's waiters and stuff.
Yeah, because you wouldn't want to put it directly on the ground, especially on the beach with a breeze, because then there'd be sand in your food.
Yeah, and we wouldn't be here in Timmins. We'd probably be on the French Riviera, wherever that is.
Wherever that is? Have you ever been there?
No. In fact, this week at work, I was telling all the people that I would not see them this coming week because I was probably going to move to Tahiti because I can't stand the weather here anymore. And
it's not that bad, though.
Well, one of the places that I said that at was a travel agency. And she's like, do you even know where Tahiti is? I think, yeah, it's over here somewhere off the coast of California. And she's like, no. It's over by New Zealand.
Yeah.
So it was totally on the other side of the world.
Yeah.
I don't know where Tahiti is.
No.
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 Apparently not. She said, if you're going to move somewhere, go to Australia.
No, don't go to Australia.
Everything there is poisonous and wants to kill you.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't want to kill you. It just will.
The people there are cool.
Yeah, the people over there are cool.
Yeah. And the weather is seasonable. I don't think they get snow. Do they get snow?
They get snow.
Yeah, they get snow.
They're as far, parts of Australia are as far south as Canada is north.
Well, then I won't live in those parts.
Well, then you could just go to southern Canada.
But, yeah, I could. I suppose. I don't know. I just don't like the snow.
Or even just British Columbia.
Yeah, but it's expensive out there.
It is?
Yeah, it's going to be expensive in the nice places.
Yeah.
Because the people want to live in the nice places, so you can charge the most money to get the most stuff.
I think I'm just going to buy a catamaran and live on my boat.
You want to live on a boat?
In the ocean.
Boats are scary. The ocean is scary.
Yeah.
Haven't you seen every ocean movie ever?
Not everyone.
Well, they're not good. They don't end well. Like, they're good movies, but they don't end well.
Or you could just live on a canal.
I could live on a canal? Where would I go for that?
Well, you're always talking about Amsterdam. You can
Amsterdam is nice.
Live on one of the canals in Amsterdam.
Oh, you're right. I should move to Amsterdam.
Yeah. Plus, it's very picturesque. Nice. Everybody's very friendly. Mm-hmm.
And my forebears are from there.
Are they?
Yes. Well, my last name is Vanderloo. That does mean from the low in Dutch.
Does it?
Yep. That's what I'm told anyway. I don't
From
the low.
Oh.
Vander means from the.
Oh.
Now you know.
Montigny means,
knowing is half the battle.
Eh? What? Knowing is half the battle, yes. Yeah. De Montigny means from the mountains.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So you're from the mountains and I'm from the valley.
High meets low.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
There's a podcast.
Katie's original last name was Sheldon.
Yeah.
It means a slightly sloping hill.
Oh, I thought it meant a pretentious kid from a TV show.
No.
Oh.
So she upgraded from a slightly sloping hill to a mountain.
Nice. So.
We're in the middle of an email.
Oh, yeah, we have the rest of the email to read. Sparky wants to know if you got to pick any sci-fi fantasy character to be your best friend from childhood to death, who would it be?
Q.
I picked Lorian from Babylon 5. Or Riker, because he taught me everything I need to know about love.
Lorian. I don't remember Lorian.
He's the first one.
Oh, the first one. Oh, okay, I remember now.
He saved Sheridan from Zahadum, gave him 20 years extra life, so I'd pick that guy.
Who would you pick? Any sci-fi?
Any character from sci-fi or fantasy?
Sci-fi.
Only sci-fi?
Only sci-fi, to be your friend.
To be my friend?
For your entire life.
This is a tough choice.
Just pick one. Who's your favorite sci-fi character?
I have so many.
Tell me one.
Ah!
Tell me!
Ah!
Quick! Hurry!
From life to death?
Yes. Tom Bombadil.
Can I pick
That's
Chi?
Fantasy.
I know.
You can pick Chi.
Who?
Chi from Chobits.
I don't know what that is.
She's a Persicom.
What? She's a personal computer.
Oh.
But they're shaped like people.
Uh-huh.
And they can do your housework, or they can work at a job, because they are shaped like people, and they move like people, and they talk like people.
Cool.
But she would well outlive me. But she's pretty cool. It's weird because it's a sci-fi anime, but the whole thing is about all relationships.
Oh.
Yeah.
Right on.
Yeah.
Cool.
And you?
She's not sci-fi. She doesn't know sci-fi stuff. I'm saying her favorite sci-fi character is going to be... Let's go...
Tony Stark.
With Tony Stark, yeah. You like Tony Stark? You like Iron Man? You want him to be your best friend?
I think we'd kind of clash.
He would make a terrible best friend. Like, I would want to be, like, friends with him, but it probably wouldn't work out because he's kind of an ass.
He's narcissistic.
He reminds me of Andrew.
Your brother.
Although, yes.
Right.
Maybe I would make good best friends with him because I'd be like, you're being an ass, Tony. Come out from your basement. Come and make me a sandwich. And he'd say, no, I got robots for that. And I'd be like, well, make them make me a sandwich.
All right. Email goes on. Thank you, everyone, for the podcast. You are the shining gem in a sea of blah casts. You make our earbuds say, hey, that's better than that rap music in Nickelback. There was a time.
What's with the hate on Nickelback? I like Nickelback.
You can take that up with Sparky and Guns.
What's up with the hate, boys? I like Nickelback.
Yeah, they're okay.
They got some good music. They're good Canadian boys. You stop that.
There was a time before cable, when the local anchorman reigned supreme, when people believed everything they heard on TV. This was an age when only men were allowed to read the news. And in Timmins, two anchormen were more men than the rest. Their names were Sparky and Guns. They were like gods walking amongst mere mortals. They had voices that could make a wolverine purr and suits so fine they made Sinatra look like a hobo. In other words, Sparky and Guns were the balls.
Make a wolverine purr.
Yeah.
Ah, that's good times.
That is good times.
Yep. You know, I know them in person.
I do know.
Their suits are very flashy.
Yeah?
Yep.
Do they make you purr?
I'm not a wolverine.
True enough.
I am a unicorn.
Right, I forget.
All right, so this week's hypothetical is a variant.
Okay, go. Tell me.
The last time we had a robot apocalypse, and you had to choose a sci-fi handheld weapon.
Yeah.
Today, it's a zombie apocalypse.
Okay.
And you must choose a fantasy weapon.
Oh, all right.
Any handheld fantasy weapon.
Uh-huh.
Not armor.
Okay.
Not a defensive item, a weapon.
You
must choose that to be your thing.
So would that include fireballs? Or, because that comes from your hand, if you're a mage, does that count? Or it has to be actual
piece a of weapon, equipment? Equipment, an object.
An object, okay.
I got one.
Okay, well, save it for next week.
I will. You can't let me forget that I got one.
You got one.
Okay.
Next week.
And I want to hear from all the listeners. I want at least three answers from each of you.
Three answers?
No, I want one answer from you. But I want at least three answers coming from the
internet?
Listeners. But I want more. Give us more, people.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. You can email us, therustedrobot@gmail.com, or tweet us at therustedrobot on Twitter.
And or you can contact us on Facebook.
Yeah, just go to facebook.com/therustedrobot and leave your thing right on the page.
And you can contact Sean at
Darth Vaderloo on Twitter or Instagram.
Or you can go to his house and knock on his door at
123 Fake Street.
Okay.
And you could buy his fake house.
Yes, buy my fake house. Buy my real house. And you know what they could do? If they wanted to do, they could email us at soulforgepodcast@gmail.com as well.
Well, that's not really emailing us.
That's my other podcast.
That's just you.
That's just me.
Yeah.
Right. But that email is pretty sparse, so I don't have a Sparky and Guns emailing the Soulforge podcast.
Well, you're going to have to dig some up.
I'm going to have to dig up some, zombies.
Yeah, you're...
Is that what you'll call your fans from the Soulforge podcast?
I never did have a good name for the fans of the Soulforge podcast. I was going to call them Soldiers, but it just didn't flow right. And Forgers, but that didn't go either. So
Smiths, they'd be Smiths.
Yeah, that's hard to say though.
Smith?
Thanks for listening, Smiths. No? Maybe.
I don't know.
Anyway, whatever. Doesn't matter.
Call them Journeymen.
Oh, Journeymen. But what if they're not men?
A journeyman is a status of an apprentice.
It's like mankind.
Yeah, I know.
Sometimes there's just a word that is all things.
All things.
Right, you just call them apprentices, just straight up.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Ooh. Because I am their guide to living a better life. So, well,
there you go.
That makes a lot of sense. All right. Well, that's been episode 176 of the Rusted Robot Podcast for the end of November. Next month, next week is December. It's almost the end of the year. We have a great NOE gala to look forward to.
Yeah, it's going to be hella sweet.
So we hope to see you all there. And remember, someday there will be robots to serve us coffee and cake before they kill us. If you'd like to contact the show, email us at therustedrobot@gmail.com. Our website is therustedrobot.podbean.com. On Twitter, we're at therustedrobot. I'm on Twitter and Instagram at Darth Vaderloo. we'd be honored if you would review us on iTunes and like us on Facebook. If you'd care to support the show, there's a PayPal link on the website, or go to patreon.com/DarthVaderLou. Please check out Jump City at 229 Pine Street South in Timmins. And as always, if you like what you heard, let us know. But most importantly, tell your friends about us. The Rusted Robot Podcast. Think about it.
I can do this all day.
I know I had a Dungeon Master screen here somewhere.
Who has my glow-in-the-dark 20-sided?
Hey, I can't find my character sheet. Where's my character?
Oh, there it is. Beer. You're gonna have to roll a save.
It's in with the Cheetos.
I kept somebody looking at my Dungeon Master screen more than twice.
I know I gave it to somebody over here and I didn't get it back.
Roll for initiative.
I can't roll.
Ugh, now it's got yellow on it.
We were skulking through this dungeon, a mighty sorry lot. Old Galliard the fighter had been acting like a sot. Our cleric had colitis, our torches all were wet. But we had to find some treasure soon to get us out of debt. So Galliard and Sonya were itching for a fight.
Come here!
They both took the left fork while we went to the right. And that is when we heard it, the sound of rolling dice. We wondered why we had ignored these words of sage advice.
Diversified portfolio.
Don't you know you never split the party? Clerics in the back keep those fighters hale and hearty. The wizard in the middle where he can shed some light. And you never let that damn thief out of sight. So then we heard this bellow from back around the bend. We turned around to see if there was aid that we could lend. And suddenly the corridor was covered up with orcs. We fell back in a panic, feeling like a bunch of dorks.
One of my dice up cubic zirconia.
The thief had pissed his leathers, our monk was turning blue. Our wizard got all flustered and he covered us with goo. The cleric swung his holy club, some orcish skulls to break. We tried to dodge his backswing as we pondered our mistake. Don't you know you never split the party? Clerics in the back keep those fighters hale and hearty. The wizard in the middle where he can shed some light. And you never let that damn thief out of sight. We finally found our fighters. They were hacking at a troll. They chopped off knees and elbows, but it kept on growing whole. Our wizard flung his fireball. His dice, they did not fail. He torched that troll and left our fighters roasting in their mail. The cleric had his hands full, apologies were said. We swore an oath we'd stick together just like we were wed.
Yes,
but then we found that sneaky thief had vanished in the gloom. We caught him stuffing pockets in the secret treasure room.
Don't you know you never split the party? Clerics in the back keep those fighters hale and hearty. The wizard in the middle where he can shed some light. And you never let that damn thief out of sight. Don't you know you never split the party? Clerics in the back keep those fighters hale and hearty. The wizard in the middle where he can shed some light. And you never let that damn thief, you never let that damn thief, you never let that damn thief out of sight.
This has been a Valley of Vanderloo podcast production, all rights reserved.
This transmission ends now.